Hello.
So, I want to show you today how I prefer to do the lapis myself for easier technique and better elegance, let's say, from my perspective. The first thing is the foot and the leg position. We can name three positions. The first one is where I have my toes stretched and inner part is touching and I'm showing the outer part of the leg. The second one is straight toe and the front part of the leg is showing, and the third part is the outer part of the leg and inner part is showing. So, 1, 2, 3. In all positions, my hip is straight and standing leg is relaxed and free, and I have a stretch axis. So we don't want to do these things, or these ones, or these, or these. We want to be stretched here, hips front and back. So we start from the zero position, going to the, we have a small V shape, we are going to the position 3. And from position 3, when we go to the side, we are turning our legs to position 1. From position 1, we are going back and staying on position 1 and coming back on position 2. And when we go to the forward again, we turn it to the position 3. So our foot is making a half circle and drawing a half circle with the toe, but the position of the foot is always changing. And the same with the other leg. Be careful not to move the hips. At the end, or while passing through the zero position, try to keep the knees together. Don't forget, when we are drawing the half circle, we don't finish it here and come. We continue and we finish it the half circle and then come here and go through the zero position with the knees together. And we will do it one more time with the embrace position. And now at the end, imagine that you want to do a 90 degrees pivot. Knees together and once more. Dissociate and 90 degrees. Dissociate and 90 degrees. Dissociate and 90 degrees. You can do the same exercise with the other side. Now imagine that your partner is doing a back ocho and starting from back ocho to a hero. She is here. So we want to draw a lapis. We want to do a lapis just in front of her while she is going. So the first thing is our upper center, our tango hearts, is giving her the direction and the speed, and our foot should go before her as if we are cleaning the space or opening the space for her. So she's coming here. Look at my foot. And here we turn her for a blocking step. She comes, I collect and exit. Important is I don't rush with the foot. It's not like this. She starts here, I don't do this and she's still there. Okay, important that we go with the same speed in a harmony. And with the upper body, I follow her and I give her the direction. And then we exit together. Also, it is possible to exit if I want to show you now this direction. After the blocking step, it is possible to exit, changing the weight here and go together. And you will do the same exercise for the other side. After you manage this lapis and this kind of exercises, you can also play with the level with your partner. For example, now we were doing it in one level. can do it also in changing the levels. A bonus exercise is to finish the lapiz with a cross. Remember, for the cross, what we were doing, we were just lifting the heel, bending the knee, and then putting the leg so that we stay on one spot. The same with the other. You can watch the cross exercise video to practice this more. And how do we use it? It's like this. We practice our lapiz and we ended it with cross. And we continue to do the same on the other side. Please don't forget to practice a lot, even at home, alone, and we hope to see you on the dance floor very soon. Take care, love. Kenara çekil babacığım, videonun önünde.